In this video, I'm going to be breaking down how Drini runs the best gun bunch offense in Madden 21. What's up, guys? My name is Cody, and I want to thank you for taking the time to watch this video. If this is your first time visiting my channel is all about helping people become the best Madden players that they could possibly become through daily tips and tricks on both the offensive side of the ball and on the defensive side of the ball. And so if you want to get better at this game, if you want to learn the latest tips and tricks in the Madden community, I want to encourage you to click the subscribe button. It is completely free to subscribe, and it will allow you to be able to stay up to date with all of the latest tips and tricks right here on the channel. Now, I have talked with some people about some of my pro player film studies. A lot of people have wanted to learn what makes Drini so special. What is it about Drini that allows him just to consistently win in Madden? And so in today's video, we're going to be taking a look at what I believe to be one of his favorite passing concepts in Madden 21. And it's a very simple concept, but it's a very effective concept out of the shotgun bunch. Now, if you've been around the channel for any length of time, you might know that I just released a gun bunch offensive guide based out of the New York Jets gun bunch. Now, Drini likes to run the Seattle bunch, but it's really for only one or two plays here and there. The major play that he likes to use out of the Seattle is the clear out, SE out. That's kind of the reason, and the read option. But I believe New York might be just a little bit better because you have the passing concept Jets dig, which is very similar to clear out, SE out, maybe even a little better in some ways. And then you also have the ability to run the play mesh, which is a very, very nice little zone beater that you can have access to. But either one is very similar. This play that we're going to be going over today, it can be found in my ebook. It can also be found in Seattle. But if you want to get my full gun bunch offensive ebook, I'm going to leave a link to that in the description. It's the entire offense broken down step by step. And in today's video, we're taking a look at the play mesh post. This is what I believe to be Drini's favorite passing concept in Madden 21. It's the play that he goes to whenever he needs a conversion, whenever he needs a big play. This, I believe, is one of his favorite passing concepts. So how do you run the play mesh post like Drini runs it and like Drini was able to do? And we're going to get into that right now. So first and foremost, this is a very good play against man-to-man coverage. And the adjustments are very simple. All you're going to do is you're going to put the square receiver or the solo receiver in the bunch side. That square receiver over there, you're going to put him on an out route. Then you're going to take the R1 receiver and you're going to put him on a slant, as you can see right there, a little slant. And then the last step is to put the tight end or the X receiver on a little out route and motion that R1 receiver to the right. Now your first read on this is this tight end out route. As you can see right there, it's a very smooth and simple route that accomplishes a lot relatively quickly. It's very, very good against man coverage. It's also very good against zone coverage, especially things like Mabel coverage or even the blitz for that matter. And so you have a nice little quick read here to your tight end that is going to be very consistent, and you're going to consistently be able to beat man-to-man coverage, which one of the common tactics of people to try to stop the tight end is to use man coverage. They like to man up the tight end when they're defending bunch. This right here, this little formula, little quick route, is going to allow you to beat man coverage with the tight end. Now, the next route that we're going to be talking about as far as man-to-man coverage goes, you really have three major reads that are going to be very effective, is your motion slant. Arguably, the best way to beat man-to-man coverage in Madden 21 is with a motion slant. As you can see, you get great separation, and you're able just to get into a very interesting little spot of the defense. Most of the time, what people like to do defensively is they will come off of the slant once he gets to like the right hash mark on this play. And if you look here, you're going to be able to beat it all the way across. You see, I mean, it's very consistent, and it just roasts man-to-man coverage. So if they come off of that, you can easily go back to that slant route. The next route on this play is going to be the circle receiver, and he is running a little sharp cutting post route. When he cuts to the inside, you're going to see that he's going to typically be able to beat man-to-man coverage. If you're playing in Madden Ultimate Team and you have a 90 or above route runner at that position, it is going to help tremendously. Tavon Austin against Jair Alexander is just not a great matchup, but as you can see, he still is able to be able to beat man-to-man coverage right to the inside just like that. Now, the beauty of this play is that it is a very good play over the middle. In fact, a lot of people, when they defend bunch, one of their go-to strategies is they like to use some type of Mabel coverage. Well, this play is very effective for Mabel coverage because if you take a look at this running back route, even though it's not that great against man-to-man coverage, if you just lowball this, you can basically fit it in against any zone coverage in the game. So if they're running zone coverage on you, One of my best pieces of advice is to use this play mesh post. That running back route is going to be wide open every single time if they're running zone coverage. The other thing that you have is, let's say that they're running some label coverage on you. If you take a look here, this tight end is going to kind of have a little bit of a window right there, but not much of one. As you can see, they have a yellow zone over there. If they don't have a yellow zone, so let's say that they're blitzing you, and this is why Drini loves this play so much, I believe, is because when he gets pressured, because his tight end is on a little quick out route, it's very simple just to low ball, just to quickly hit it, just to simply quickly hit it. The flat zone or the underneath zones, they are going to jump to the outside relatively quickly. And so it's going to leave a small window of opportunity for you to be able to hit this X receiver. I'll show you right here. Again, just snap, go. And as you can see, I can hit that route. There's no hard flats. Even if there is hard flats, I'm able to hit that out route, which is the beauty of it, as it's not just a traditional flat route. It's an out route. And Drini is very, very much so very effective with that out route. Now, the other route that I want to talk about as far as a blitz perspective, and this is where you're just basically identifying where does the user go, because if the user doesn't go to the left side, that running back route is very, very effective against that blitzing coverage as well. And then the last thing that I want to hit on as far as Mabel coverage goes is the situation where, you know, they might take their user, and they're going to take their user and they're going to man him up onto the running back, or they're going to cover the running back basically, and it's like, well, what do I do in that scenario? That's where you can work this little slant out route combination. You know, you have multiple routes that are coming open at multiple different points, and that's what makes the gun bunch offense so, so effective. And so if you want to learn my entire gun bunch offensive guide, I'm going to leave a link to that in the description. It literally walks you through step by step how to run the gun bunch in a very, very elite way. I've been running the gun bunch for years, and this year is back and probably the best offense in the entire game. And so if you want to learn exactly how I run the gun bunch in tournaments and in money games, you can get that offensive guide in the description. It's on sale for just $15, and it is probably, like I said, it is definitely at least one of the top two or three offenses in the game this year, but I believe it's probably the best offense. So if you want to get that offensive guide, all you got to do is head down into the description. There'll be a link that you can click right there. It'll take you right to the checkout. If you have any questions about this this video, go ahead and text me. My number will be in the description. And then the last thing I did want to let you know is we will be streaming this evening at 8 o'clock p.m. Eastern time right here on the channel. So if you want to come by, hang out, if you want to play Madden with me online, we can do that as well. Thanks for your support. I really appreciate it. And again, if you want to get that Gun Bunch offensive guide, it is going to be available for you in the description.